Kebaya Nyonya is, like I say, it's a mix between Chinese and Malay. So the embroidery, the embellishment is definitely from the Chinese influence. Okay? The shape, the form of the baju is from the Malay community. Also, the combination of fabric that they've been used, like the embroidered garment and the batik, also is the mixed culture of these two traditions. As far as the motif is concerned, many of the motifs that have been used in Kebaya Nyonya, they have used lotus, phoenix, you know, the flowers in the Chinese community, which brings meaning for prosperity, good luck, you know, and all that. And they have also used bright colors to bring in, to blend in the principles and the philosophy of the Chinese tradition with the Malay tradition.
Kebaya is actually worn by women, especially younger women those days. So the style of, or the colours are more vibrant, and then the motifs that's used is very much related to women, femininity. So there's a lot of flower, there's birds, you know, something that is nice, something nature. So it's very colourful, so a lot of that motifs are being used.
Good quality kebayas are not cheap because they are all basically hand designed and sewn, hand sewn. Yeah.
It's fashion evolution because when you see the youngsters when they wear kebaya Nyonya, they don't just wear it as it is, but they wear it with jeans, they wear it with skirts, and then they will be conflict with the traditional people. They will tell you there is a wrong way of wearing your traditional clothes.
I think mostly people stop wearing kebaya maybe because they find that it's very restrictive. The fast modern generation find that, you know, using the kebaya is a hindrance to, you know, their work. You know, like they want to move fast, they want to travel fast. When people opt to be more modern, so they drop out all this wearing kebaya.
It first, we have to educate the young ones right from the beginning. They must really feel the tradition to wear the dress.
To educate people about what Kebaya Nyonya is about. When we educate, we create awareness. Then you will develop interest, and from there, you will encourage them to wear it, use it. And I think another step further that we can go ahead and do is to actually develop it by getting classes for people to learn how to sew it, because it's a dying art.
And finally, I would say that, you know, the day we stop wearing kebaya is the day that we will lose our culture, because the kebaya is definitely one of the key identity, physical expression of our culture.
I would like to encourage the young Malaysians, right, to know about the art of Kebaya Nyonya and also to wear the costume, so that the art will live longer in our community in the future.
One way to actually bring back kebaya is actually to practice using it. I mean, previously a lot of people think that using kebaya is like very difficult, very a lot of hassle. But I think people should see that wearing kebaya brings out the femininity in women.